another one down, Kerry. How much more time are we going to waste on this bastard?
We're not wasting time. We are doing exactly what we should be doing until the tech team gets here.
That's not what it looks like to me.
You see Detective Darwin's theory of evolution.
Survival of the fittest. Based on his little trip to the Galapagos, no longer applies on this planet. We have a human race that doesn't have the edge or the will to survive.
The fuck do you want?
It's hard to remain calm, isn't it, when your son is walking around on those monitors?
I can't give you what you want if you don't know what the fuck it is.
I told you what it is. Just remember the rules.
No, you said you wanted to talk. Then you said you wanted to play a game. You're talking, but it means nothing!
What do you think the cure for cancer is, Eric?
What?
The cure for cancer. What is it?
I don't know what it is. But I know it's not killing and torturing people for your own sick fucking pleasure.
I've never murdered anyone in my life. The decisions are up to them.
Yeah, well, putting a gun to someone's head and forcing them to pull the trigger is still murder.
Since when is force a problem for you? Why are you so desperate to get your son back?
Because he's my son.
What's the last thing you said to him before you left him?
Oh my God!
It seems to me that the knowledge of your son's impending death is causing you to act. Forgive all his sins, to wipe the slate clean. Why is it that we're only willing to do that when a life is at stake?
I've always loved my son. That's never changed.
No, no. It's changed now. You see, the knowledge of death changes everything. If I were to tell you the exact date and time of your own death, it would shatter your world completely. I know. Can you imagine what it feels like to have someone sit you down?
John Kramer?
And tell you that you're dying. The gravity of that. That the clock's ticking for you. In a split second, your world's cracked open. You look at things differently, you smell things differently. You savor everything, be it a glass of water or a walk in the park.
The clock is ticking, John.
But most people have the luxury of not knowing when that clock's gonna go off. And the irony of it is that that keeps them from really living their life. It keeps them sleepwalking. It keeps them drinking that glass of water, but never really tasting it.
You can still fix this, John.
Yeah, but can we fix you?
I mean,
I'm not fixable. I've had cancer.
Cancer is an excuse for what you do.
No. The cancer isn't what started me in my work. It was the moment I decided to end my life that started me in my work and brought meaning to it. I had literally driven myself to suicide, and I had failed. My body had not been strong enough to repel cancer cells. Yet I had lived through a plunge off a cliff. But to my amazement, I was alive. And I was determined to spend the rest of my days testing the fabric of human nature. Do you understand, Eric?
You got a chance to do something good right now, John. Tell me where my son is. I'll help you.
I don't need your help, and I can tell you still don't understand. Those who don't appreciate life do not deserve life.
My son appreciates his life.
But do you appreciate yours? Do you appreciate your son's?
Oh, this shit!
Don't forget the rules. If you want to find your son.
Where are you? No, we don't have 15 minutes. We need that location to the video feed.